that you can experiment.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and then sit with your sitting bones off the, like that. And yeah.
Just
see how you go. So we'll have a break, and one of the things you can do is maybe prepare a meditation spot for yourselves. And there's blankets in the rooms, which you haven't gone to yet, but we'll show you there.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can put in a blanket for yourself and make it all nice and cozy. All right, anyway, back to the meditation. All right, so I'll go first, and then I'll, when I stop, it'll go to Tracy. It'll go to Shirley, and then I'll go to Tracy and Gosha, and then we might go around twice or three times like that. You can just say one word or one sentence or go on for a little bit. We might just sort of start with one word and then sort of go from there. So we're going to try and get into standing conscious. All right, we're ready to go. So we become aware of our consciousness. What is this presence that is awareness that is beyond the thinking mind? For me, it's incredibly spacious and open.
For me, it's like the universe. It's like looking into a giant cosmos, but it's not completely black.
For me, it's quiet and calm.
For me, it's neither good or bad.
Awareness is ever present. It's like it's the space that holds all forms. It's the silence which holds all sounds. The energy that holds all feelings. It's like the luminescent foundation in which everything is reflected. It's almost like a mirror, where the mirror is pristine and untouched, while reflecting an infinite number of images within the mirror.
Awareness is noticing everything, than just noticing.
It just sits back and it just is. It's just there.
It's acceptance.
Yeah, it's just accepting, because in awareness there's no good, no bad, no judgment. No, should be one way or the other. It's as equally accepting of negative as positive. And it's completely, in that acceptance, is completely relaxing. just letting go of just accepting whatever is.
Excuse me. Awareness is non-attachment, seeing but not clinging, not attaching.
It's non-judgmental.
Limitless. Yeah, awareness is, it's obviously who I am, and yet at the same time it feels almost bigger than me. It's as if, yeah, the awareness of the body and mind are just subsets of this much larger thing we call awareness. Because awareness includes everything around us, whatever we're sensing, and in fact, infinitely beyond that. And now, in kind of feeling into that awareness, do you feel that there is a sense of calmness that is there more so than before?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is really one way to pacify the mind and to go into awareness for some time. And get into that state of relaxation, because in that there is no clinging and aversion. And then if that's the way you want to go, you can do that for a little while, and then become aware of a sense that the body is the energy body, and become aware of the energy body. And you can become aware of the energy body as if it's separate to the body, or you can become aware that the physical body and the energy body are one, and you can contemplate things like, for example, I'm sure you do know that physics now tells us that there's really no such thing as solidity. So, you know, we think something is solid, but it's made up of atoms, you know, which are 99.9% space and tiny little nucleus and a few electrons. But now we even know that even those are not really particles, they are just energy, they're wavelengths of energy. So when you think that the body is all space, and yet even then it's just wavelengths of energy, you know, it could be closer to say that we are an energy body. So the point is actually not to sort of prove to you one way or the other. It actually doesn't matter. The point is, what is helpful in you contemplating an idea that allows you to be more sensitive to what's going on in your mind. And if those ideas help you tune into this idea of an energy body, then you can use that. So however you visualize an energy body, you can imagine it as energy, you can imagine it as a yellow energy or a blue energy, or you can imagine it sort of extending out past the body, you know, as far as you like. So imagine sort of a bubble of energy, however you wish to do it. You can do that, and then let the awareness feel this energy body, as if this energy body is made up completely of awareness. And at some point, I'm sure you will start to feel that energetic quality. Now, that itself can be a meditation object, and it's a very good meditation object. Eventually, and I hope that one of the ideas in this meta retreat is, as you concentrate on meta more and more, that energy body will have a more and more beautiful presence about it. And as that happens, you will start to get blissful. They talk about rapture, bliss, things like that. And when that happens, the mind wants to stay with the energy body because it also feels good. And at that point, it's much easier to get rid of the distractions. So you can see that we're actually kind of creating a bit of a feedback loop here by sensing into a sense of well-being in the energy body. And then that well-being helps us stay concentrated. And then when we're concentrated, we only need to just drop in a sense of gratefulness, of feeling grateful for everything that we have, or a sense of, you know, being really moved by something our brother did for us, or something like that. And because of that samadhi and because of that concentration, it will have a much more profound effect than just, oh yeah, well, it was a nice thing, and then you move on. Okay, it actually really resonates in the body, and the feedback loop continues, and it's more easier to stay concentrated. So we want to taste the energetic quality, and we want to tune into it, and yeah, you can feel the body, but you can also use your other senses like visualization, you know, a body of light. Even hearing, maybe you can hear it, I don't know. So you can use all the sense, taste it, smell it, if you want, if you can. But visualization, obviously, and feeling it are the two main modalities that you'll be using to sense this energy body. All right, so I want to have a practice with that. And then we'll have a break, and I need to find out where Kate is. She's supposed to be dropping off our soup for the evening. So we'll do that. Are you okay for another meditation? Mm-hmm. Still good? All right. So I'll do a little bit of guiding, but generally it's up to you to try to sense into this energy body. Starting with the physical body, making sure that physically we're sitting in good meditation posture, connected to the ground, legs either crossed or sitting on a meditation stool, connected with the earth. Just being aware of the back, making sure the back is not tensed but nice and straight as it's being pulled up by the crown. Our hands folded in our lap, right hand and left hand with the two thumbs touching is the classical posture. But whatever is comfortable for you. Our arms held perhaps slightly away from the body, but loosely, and in particular, making sure that our shoulders are relaxed, our shoulder blades are relaxed, and we're not holding any tension in our shoulders or back. Feeling that the whole torso and the head are just balanced perfectly on our hips so that they stay upright with very little effort. Our head should be an extension of our torso, balanced on our shoulders as if being, you know, again straight as if it was being lifted up by the crown, or just balanced, you know, like the perfect snowman. Our jaw relaxed, no tension in the back of our jaw, and our eyes gazing forward, downwards at about 45 degrees or lightly closed. And then perhaps being aware of our breath, the movement of our breath in and out. And as we breathe in and out, we can visualize that not only are we breathing in oxygen, you can visualize it as energy that you're breathing in and out of. And this energy is not only circulating down to our lungs, but circulating through our whole body. You know, different traditions have different words, chi, prana, lung, for example. And I'd like you to begin to perceive that this energy is flowing through our whole body. You can visualize it as beautiful golden light or white light or whichever color you prefer, moving through the body. And possibly even extending out from the physical body, as if you have a way of sensing things around you through this energy body. Tuning into this energy body, visualizing it how you prefer in your own preference, and imbuing this energy body with complete awareness and acceptance of what is, and use that as your meditation object. You can be aware of the breath. You may notice as you do this meditation that it's easy on the in-breath to get a sense of this energy expanding, sort of expanding away from the body, as if you're filling the energy body up with energy on the in-breath. And on the out-breath, you can visualize a relaxation, as if the energy body is becoming more peaceful and just letting go into the awareness state. So if it helps, you can still be aware of the breath interacting with the energy body. Again, experiment, play, and find what works best for you. any time you get a sense of feeling that energy, have that as your in, as your meditation object. Sometimes people feel a tingling in the hands or the feet as one of the first signs of sort of pervasion of energy in our body. But wherever you feel it, just tune into that feeling of flow of energy through your body as the meditation object. Thank you.